But then you turn and walk away.
Just when you thought you knew the rules, the game changes. We must change with it.
Somebody told me
we can make it better. We can make it.
Somebody told me
we can make it better. We can make it.
Somebody told me
we can make it better. We can make it.
Somebody told me
we can make it better. We can make it.
Somebody told me
that we can make it better.
We can make it better.
We can make it better.
We can.
Good luck to you. And those who tell us that we can't, we will respond with that timeless creed that sums up the spirit of a people. Yes, we can.
I think the president, you know, gave us hope. I think he's accomplished something that I didn't think would be done in my lifetime. I think he's given us an opportunity to believe that we can rise to higher heights. But as someone said here earlier, he's just one man. And being one man, he's only limited to certain things that he can and can't do. But more than anything else, he's gave, you know, Black America hope.
The whole notion of a game changer, that there is a single thing we're going to do that's going to make a substantial change. That's not true. That is not true at all. It's going to be this 10, 15 year long commitment to a small piece that you're going to stick with. And so if you want to call it a game changer, the game changer is sacrifice. It's, yeah, I'm going to take in this child that I don't know, who without me doesn't have any positive male or adult influence, and I'm gonna commit to mentoring that child until they graduate. I'm gonna spend days, I might adopt some children that need to be adopted.
What Black men and boys need in this country is access to information and resources. They brothers need jobs. Brothers need to know how they can become entrepreneurs, how they can start their own businesses, back to jobs. What do we need to do to prepare ourselves for job interviews? How should we dress? How should we speak? You know, how do I take my skill sets to the next level? If I don't have a high school diploma, should I go back to high school? Should I go get a GED? Should I stop there? How do I go to a community college or a four-year college? How do I go to vocational schools that are reputable and not these bogus schools that just take my money or get me caught up in debt? Those are the kind of things that I see Black males needing. Brothers need to know what it is to be a man.
Young Black men are changing the game and changing the conversation every single day. Young Black men are doing things that are not reported. They are striving, they are excelling, they are doing well in the society and overcoming often insurmountable odds to be successful. And the issue is that all too often media does not report those stories. Every day here in this building at the Brotherhood Sister Soul, young men are changing the game. Young men are doing unbelievable things. And yet, that's not reported. But if there's some kind of gang activity on the block, if there's a shooting, if there's any kind of negative activity that occurs, it's all over the media. And I think part of it is about trying to put forward stories that tell a different story, to try to change the narrative of what it means to be a young Black man in this society.
we understand our history and our culture, then education, job readiness, workforce development issues, all those things that we know are important are going to be coming to the fore. That our ancestors, people like Malcolm, people like Harriet Tubman, people like Ella Baker and September Clark and many countless others, basically said to us, if you understand where you come from, if you understand what makes for good values and principles around, for instance, the ancient values of Ma'at, of being truthful, of doing righteousness, of bringing social change, you can't do any of that if you don't have an education. You can't do any of that if you don't have proper housing. You can't do any of that if you're not really taking care of your own children and your own family. So for me, the game changer is for us to understand who we really are, not who we think we are, but who we really are. And then be able to pass that on to other people, stand on that strong history, stand on that strong culture, and then be able to pass it on to our children so that every generation going forward really understands their role, who they are, where they come from, and what the possibilities are.
One of the problems is that we lack education. Most of us are very ignorant of our own past, our own selves. And the problem with that is that if you don't know anything about yourself, then you can't develop what Du Bois call a true self-consciousness, that is to know who is you are. But the overall basic problem is about employment, that as the slave people, the people who still have not completely overcome their slave status, which is why a lot of us don't even understand that only one group of people in this country was slaves, right here in the bottom of a boat. And to overcome that, it takes some kind of steady economic base, you know, which is employment, and it takes some education, and it takes some culture, that is to reflect on the history of your own life to know who you are. And those are the things that have to be built.
There's a familiar story from our history about a particular group of black men and boys, a group of black people in general, who after being fed up with the day-to-day soul-crushing conditions of their circumstances, simply made a choice to rise up and find their greatness. The famous Haitian leader Toussaint Louverture became the recognized leader of their revolution, but it was the masses, everyday black folks, who collectively decided enough was enough. They changed themselves, they changed history, they changed the game. The 2025 campaign for black men and boys asked the question our ancestors answered for us long ago. What will we do to be the change, to change the game?
My name is Kwesi and I am a game changer.
This project is really intimate to me because I have a black boy. This project is very intimate to me because I see a lot of black boys, our brothers basically hanging out on corners, and my passion is to make sure that their lives are valued in the same way that I value my son's life.
Because Barack Obama is president doesn't mean I can be president. It doesn't really quite mean that, but it does mean that because he's president, because he's a black man, because I'm a black man, there's not something inherently limiting about me and really the highest seat of power and leadership in our country.
My name is Marcus Littles. I'm with Frontline Solutions in Brooklyn, New York. And this is The Game Changer.
Well, what do you want to be when you grow up?
I want to be an engineer.
Wow. Why?
Because
the pain is gone.
I like doing like robotics and making like those things, rockets and stuff like that.